Evening, everyone. We have with us Dr. Tanaya Sarnaik today. So just a brief introduction about her. She's a sports physiotherapist at Reliver Physiotherapy and Rehab since 2018. She's a gold medal in sports physiotherapy from D.Y. Patil University. She's worked as sports physiotherapist for under-17 FIFA World Cup, MCA matches, Kanga League, and the Purushottam Shield. She has also worked as a sports physiotherapist for SFA badminton tournaments held at D.Y. Patil Stadium and for under-15 football team affiliated to All India Football Federation. It's a pleasure to have Dr. Tanaya on board with us today. Thank you so much,
Meg. It's a pleasure for me as well to be a part of the team today. As Meg has introduced me, but I am Dr. Tanaya Sarnaik, and we will be having our webinar today on the essence of running. That is, we'll be concentrating on the entire sport of running.
So if anyone has any doubts or queries, I think we can put it up on the chat box or you can unmute yourself.
Yeah, definitely.
Ma'am?
Yeah, hi. Can I know your name, please?
Yeah, I'm Kashish Thakkar.
Hi, Kashish. Please tell me.
Hi. Yeah, so ma'am, what I wanted to ask is that ACL injury is the most common, you know, knee injury that all the players face, you know, like football right. players and all. So usually the treatment for that is like, you know, knee arthroscopy or something like that. So is it necessary that if you have an ACL tear or something that you necessarily have to go for, you know, operation or something, or only physiotherapy can't cure ACL?
No, actually the thing is, see, whenever there is an ACL injury, you always are, you know, more precise with an MRI report, or, you know, when there is a call for an surgery. So we have the grades of your ACL tear. It's either grade 1, grade 2, grade 3. So as per your grade or the tear of the ACL, accordingly, it is decided definitely that whether the patient has to go for an arthroscopic repair or does not have to. So when he or she is in the initial range, like say for the grade 1 or grade 2 tear, definitely we can work very well with your physiotherapy, because it has done miracles and actually works very well in strengthening your ACL and avoiding the ongo for your arthroscopic repair. But in cases when it is really high tear, there is, you know, a need for an arthroscopic repair. When the patient or the player has to get back to sport very earlier, or is scheduled for a 6 months or a 1 year span and has to get back to sport, it is advisable to go for an arthroscopic repair and have a really very good physiotherapy rehab post your arthroscopic repair. So definitely it depends upon your grade. I would very highlightingly say that depends upon the grade, and accordingly it is decided whether it's just physio or it is along with surgery and physio.
Okay, thank you so much, ma'am.
Most welcome, yeah. Yes, anyone else? Yeah,
hello? Hi, ma'am.
Hi,
yeah, Akanksha. This is Akanksha. Yeah. So, you spoke about the intrinsic and extrinsic factors that lead to injuries. So in the primary one, you mentioned muscle imbalance, and in the secondary one, you spoke about problems in the kinetic chain.
Yeah.
So could you just explain the difference between these two, the muscle imbalance?
See, muscle imbalance is something that can result due to either your weakness of the muscle or due to, you know, either less of stretching of your muscle. But when it comes in terms to your kinetic chain, so kinetic chain is something that involves your entire either upper body or your lower body. That is in sync. As I mentioned to you in the webinar, that, you know, always when we are concentrating on any particular joint, make sure your proximal and distal also is, you know, trained for the same. So when I say in terms of kinetic chain, it is a chain. That is, your every joint of the lower body as well as the upper body has to be properly aligned in terms of your posture, in terms of your, you know, proper strengthening, stretching, such that there is a proper alignment in the kinetic chain. But when I say muscle imbalance, it's just precisely to a particular muscle, either due to weakness or due to an over tightness of the muscle, that can result to your injury.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, most welcome.
Ma'am, I think there's a question in the chat box.
Yeah, I just saw it. One second. What stretching to do in case of excessive fibular curl? Yeah, so this question can be answered in cases of such a condition, make sure you're stretching your gastro and your soleus very well. Along with your TA stretching and along with your ham stretching, the most important stretch that you can do is your gastro and soleus. So make sure that you stretch your gastro and soleus for at least 3 reps for each of the stretch, almost 30 seconds hold. And initial with the protocol, you know, start off with at least thrice a day, and slowly onwards you can get it to a week and so. So make sure you're doing it importantly for the gastro and soleus and not ruling it out. I hope I just skipped the name who has asked it by, but I hope the answer is given well and no further queries regarding to it. If any so, you can ask me.
Right. So I would like to follow up on this question of excessive fibula curl. So what exactly, like what gastro and soleus stretching, as you said, we can do, but what are the specific stretches that we can do for the same?
Yeah, so ones with the wall, like, you know, ankle towards the wall and just moving forward, then even your lunges for a matter, lunge. But when the leg which is behind, that is, example, you're forward lunging for the left leg, the right leg has a good soleus and the gastro stretch. So these are the few stretches which you can do in your, you know, static position to avoid the risk of your fibula, like the fibula curl which you were mentioning. So these are the few stretches which you can definitely do, along with your towel stretches, like, you know, in the supine lying position, when we pull the towel towards us, like for the ankle. So this specifically acts for your TA, but when you do for the wall, the lunge stretch and all can activate your gastro and the soleus very well. So we can practice that for reducing the risk.
Okay, thank you.
Most welcome.
So if there are not any more queries, I think we can, you know, go on to the end of the seminar. Dr. Tanaya, I would like to really thank you a lot for conducting this session for us. It was really informative.
Yes, it's my pleasure.
I hope everyone learned a lot from this session. Thank you.
Thank you so much. And any queries post the session also, always feel free to contact. And, you know, we can have a really good session to always reduce the risk of injuries in all the players, not just runners, but all the sports.